Standard 8, Crossing the River, Supplementary, Unit 4. It is written by Manoj Das, who is an award-winning Indian author who writes in Odia and English. He is bestowed with many awards, and his deeper quest led him to mysticism, and has been an inmate of Sri Aurobindo Ashram in Puducherry since 1963. This is a beautiful story about a milkmaid. So come on, let us see the lesson. Now I'll read it for you. Crossing the River. The celebrated pundit had many disciples and admirers. Among them was the landlord of the area, who lived on the other side of the river. The landlord had commissioned a poor milkmaid Moti to supply a tumbler full of milk to the pundit every day in the morning. The milkmaid discharged her duty faithfully day after day. She crossed the river by the help of a ferry boat and returned home in the same way after delivering the milk at the pandit's household. Often the pandit himself received the milk. Moti prostrated before him. She did not fail in her duty even if on smoke days it rained heavily. What a great privilege it is to serve a great pandit, she would tell those toil who would sympathize with her for her continuous toil. The pandit was an eloquent speaker. Whenever he gave a discourse, hundreds of people gathered to listen to him. The milkmaid too made it a point to stand behind the audience. Not that she understood much, but she was sure that the pandit was speaking about God and truth and similar tough and complex matters. How much knowledge the man must be possessing to hold so many spellbound for hours. Only one who is very near to God and truth can command such wisdom, she thought. She was happy that she made a humble contribution towards the pandit's physical well-being by regularly supplying him with pure milk. So the story starts about a pandit. It tells about a pandit. He was a celebrated person. Pandit means a sage, a well-educated sage. He had many disciples and admirers. So disciples means people who follow what he says, listens to him, his students, and admirers. So he had many admirers also, because he was very clever and he used to give good discourses. So everybody were admiring him. Many were there. So among them was a landlord of the area who lived on the other side of the river. So on the other side of the river there was a landlord. He also admired this pandit. So the landlord commissioned a poor milkmaid. So he arranged a poor milkmaid, Moti, her name was, to bring a tumbler full of milk to the pandit every day in the morning. The milkmaid discharged her duty faithfully day after day, because she had to cross the river and come. But she used to come alone in the boat and then bring the in a ferry boat and give him the milk and go. Every day early morning she used to come. She crossed the river in a boat and she used to return back home the same day, same way as she came. So often the pandit himself received the milk. Then Moti would prostrate before him. Prostrate means kneel down and touch his feet, because he was a pandit, isn't it? So for due respect she used to pay. She did not fail in her duty even on smoke days. Even when it rained heavily she used to come. What a great privilege, she used to think, because she used to think that such a great person, to give him, to do a service to him is something prestigious for her. So she was privileged to do that. So she liked it very much and she enjoyed coming and helping the pandit, because the pandit was she admired him for his knowledge. The pandit was an eloquent speaker. He was a very fluent and expressive. Eloquent means very fluent. He used to tell many stories and make the people understand the reality of life. He used to give discussions with the discourse means discussions with people who gathered before him. The milkmaid too made it a point to stand behind the audience. So she used to stand there and listen to what he used to tell every day, his discourse. God and truth and similar tough and complex matters. The pandit was speaking about God truth and so many different difficult matters, so many things difficult. So how much knowledge the man must be possessing, she used to think. She used to be spellbound, means shocked, and she used to admire him for his knowledge. Only one who is very near to God from truth can command such wisdom, she thought. So because he's very near to God, he's like a God, because he knows so much, he's very brilliant. So she used to admire him. She was happy that she could make a small help for him every day by bringing him milk. Even if the landlord fails to pay me for the milk and my labor, I will not fail in my duty, she resolved. So she's telling, she was determined. She determined herself, decided herself, that even if the landlord doesn't give her milk or for her labor, he doesn't pay the money, she will come regularly, and she would come regularly and help him. So one day while receiving the milk, the Pandit told Moti, woman, can you bring the milk at the least an hour before the sunrise for only a month? So the Pandit is requesting her to bring for a month, that is earlier. Then she used to come at sunrise. Before the sunrise, you bring. I will not fail in my, I am under a vow for performing a certain ritual for which I need the milk that early. So he's telling that he's performing a ritual. Ritual means a religious ceremony. So he wants milk for that puja. So he's asking her to bring the milk before sunrise, for at least for a month, only for a month. So I will do as you say, O master, the milkmaid assured him enthusiastically. So she was very much happy because the Pandit had talked to her, in fact requested her. So she was very much enthusiastically answering that she will do it. Immediately she answered. So next day, it was already daybreak, she reached Pandit's house. Pardon me, master. So daybreak, so that means it has become already early morning, the sun has already risen. So she's asking sorry to her master. Pardon me means to forgive her, because she for her late, she apologized. That means she's regretting and acknowledging that she made a mistake. I was present on the bank of the river long before sunrise, but the boatman did not come up. She explained to the boatman that she was in need of crossing the river, but he said that since the rivers were in spate, that means the rivers were full of water, it was rushing hard, it would not be possible for him to ply the boat in darkness. The Pandit immediately asked her, without the boatman you are not able to cross the river, is it? Then how do they say that? Just by uttering the name of God, even life, the ocean of life can be crossed easily. That way the Pandit made fun of her. The woman could not understand what the man, actually the Pandit said. She said, no, nobody told me that, sir. That way she said. So that is a secret, said the Pandit, once again, jokingly. So again, the Pandit is making, just for a joke, he's telling, that is a secret. If you utter the name of God, you can cross everything. So who but a pious and great sage like you would ever know such secrets? Thank you, sir, for passing it on to me. So Moti immediately, because of her innocence, no, she didn't understand that he was making fun of her, but rather she was dedicated. So she said, whatever you are telling may be true only because you are such a great man, great sage. So I really respect you. So I understand only you will know such secrets. So thank you for sharing with me. That way she's telling. The Pandit could not check himself from bursting into a loud guffaw at the woman's naivety. So the Pandit couldn't control his laugh because he was just thinking such an innocent lady. She's whatever I tell, she's believing. That way he was thinking about the lady and laughing, but he could not control. He just went away. Then after that, so many days passed, and the milkmaid came daily. She used to give him the milk regularly before sunrise. Days passed, and the Pandit, the period of Pandit's vow came to an end. Then he told the milkmaid, Moti, I must say that you served me very well. He appreciated her because she had taken the pain in getting in the early hours of the day. So I bless you, that way she said. Moti bowed to him. Sir, from tomorrow I report as before, soon before, after the sunrise. Is that all right? So from tomorrow if I come, after the sunrise is enough, no sir? That way she's asking. Fine, said the Pandit. Then he remembered the boatman. Now, the boatman, how pleased I am with him. So she's telling, I am really pleased with the boatman because the boatman helped you to reach the in the correct time. But sir, I never bothered him, knowing will that he could not come that early. So after, I knew that he cannot come that early, so I never bothered him, that way she's telling. Then he was the sage was astonished. He asked him, then who came with you? How did you cross the river? Then who can remember hundreds of pages of scriptures, forgot the secrets you passed to me the other day? She's asking innocently. You gave me a secret on that day, no? I followed that, that way she's telling. So with curiosity he's asking, the Pandit is asking, what are you saying? The milk, that is the milkmaid, no? She said, really, I just uttered the name of Vishnu, Lord Vishnu, and I crossed the river easily, she said. And the water remains ankle deep for me. It never comes up. It only was ankle deep for me. Ankle deep. But isn't the river in spate? Isn't it fact that even in the hottest summer, there is enough water in the river for boats to ply? Asked the Pandit. So it's very dangerous. No, it's full of water. How could you do that? What are you saying that way? The astonished sage asked her. But she replied very coolly, I applied the secret, what you told me. Your secret formula. Oh, so now you remembered, said Moti, feeling happy. From tomorrow I will take recourse to the boat. Let me apply the secret for the last time, whole returning today. So she said, so this is the last time I'm going to apply the secret of crossing, and tomorrow onwards I will be going back in the boat only. So now upon reaching the river bank, Moti turned and she started to cross the river. And the sage almost really, he fainted. He was dumbstruck. How she was crossing, he was waiting to see that. And Moti put her empty pot down and with folded hands paid obeisance to the river. That means she was praying to the river. Then picking up the pot, she stepped into the river. Struck dumb, the Pandit saw her crossing the river, walking with ease. So he was walking as though she was walking the normal road, and the Pandit really fainted. So children, what do you understand from this story? Is it possible to walk like that? Yes. So the author beautifully stresses the importance of faith. See, the simple lady who is uneducated, who is very innocent, she is able to achieve, that is such a big faith she had on God. So children, faith removes fears, and so she was able to cross the river with ease. But the Pandit, who was very, very clever, who was very knowledgeable, who was a very great scholar, he remained with a mere theory, that is, he didn't believe, have faith. So we should understand that mere knowledge doesn't achieve anything. We should be having faith in whatever we do, faith in God, so that we can achieve and great, great miracles will happen in our life. So the author beautifully explains that knowledge, mere knowledge and scholarship will never do anything in our life. Everything, innocence and the faith will win. Faith can move mountains. That means, so any difficulty we can cross over with faith. So believe in yourself, believe in God, everything we can achieve. So that is what the poet, the author wants to tell in this story. So hope you enjoy the story. Thank you, boys. Thank you.